Hey there. Personal question right off the bat, and let me know if I'm getting too awkward. Have you been drinking the correct amount of water each day? I don't mean to sound like your mom or anything, but given our hectic schedules, it is easy to forget. I've worked all day sometimes without realizing that I've been downing nothing but coffee and soda for hours. 60% of the adult body is comprised of water, and in order to maintain your health, it's good to drink a few cups a day, but it is easy to overdo. Did you know there's such thing as alcohol intoxication? Let's talk about 9 things that happen when you drink too much water. Does it cause you to vomit? Can water actually make your stomach hurt? We're talking all that and more. Number 1. Vomiting. Alright, hold on a second. Vomiting? Like throwing up? Are you sure you've been drinking just water? It's true. If you drink enough water, you can develop something known as hyponatremia. This is when you are consuming more water than you can urinate. The fluids will soon wash the sodium out of your bloodstream, causing you to grow confused and begin to get sick. Number 2. Nausea. Vomiting obviously stinks, both figuratively and literally, but there's sometimes nothing more uncomfortable than that feeling that you're going to be sick. We've all been there, sitting around peacefully watching 13 Reasons Why on Netflix, and all of a sudden you get this queasy, awful feeling in the pit of your stomach. You even feel a little dizzy. This is nausea. Here's how it all happens. If you've been consuming large amounts of water too quickly, your stomach does not have enough time to empty, causing the fluids to build up and your insides to ache. Another factor that many do not consider is possible bacteria that may linger inside the water you're drinking. So watch out for that and make sure you're consuming water from a clean source. Number 3. Fatigue. Let's keep with the theme of sickness for a second. You may have felt a little bit of discomfort after drinking too much water, but until your kidneys are affected, you ain't seen nothing yet. When your system has had too much water, your kidneys will begin pounding away to remove as much as possible. Since they'll be working twice as hard as they usually do, you are going to feel tired. This is the fatigue state. Number 4. Headaches. Are you a wild drinker? Well, we've all suffered at the hands of that brutal hangover headache, right? But a water headache? This might be something new to a lot of you. It's been said that adults should be drinking somewhere in the vicinity of 8 glasses of water per day. But medical professionals have stated that there's actually no scientific data to support this. If you are aiming for the 8 glass number each day, you may soon experience symptoms of overhydration. Remember that fancy word I brought up a minute ago? Hyponatremia? Well, when the sodium leaves your bloodstream, your body begins to swell. This eventually puts pressure on your brain cells and causes it to begin swelling itself. This leads to a massive, throbbing headache that can prove to be too much to bear. Number 5. Double vision. It's time to unveil yet another fancy word. Ever heard of hydrocephalus? I had it until a couple minutes ago. While fluid in your stomach can build up and cause nausea, hydrocephalus is the buildup of fluids in the cavities of your brain. The excess of this fluid puts pressure on the organ. While it's mostly common for people over the age of 60, many younger people can find themselves at its mercy. Alright, stop being pretentious. Yeah, see, I know some fancy words too. What does this have to do with double vision? Well, when too much pressure is put on the brain during hydrocephalus, your sight can become impaired. Haha, yeah, I get it. So if drunk people have beer goggles, do overhydrated people have water goggles? Cheesy? Yeah, I thought so. Okay, man, can I get to more important stuff, please? This may have nothing to do with double vision, but before we move on, do you want to learn more about eyes? What kind of question is that? Well, eyes are interesting, aren't they? I mean, I guess so. Wow, you've really got an interesting way of luring folks in. I know, right? It's a gift. Check out our video on what your eye color says about you. Also, if you're interested in how to read into people from their eyes, check out 7 ways to tell if someone's lying to you. Now back to our water talk. Number 6. Clear urine. Oh yeah, we're getting into the juicy stuff. Alright, maybe that was the wrong description. Many might associate clear urine with good health, but the truth is, if your urine is completely clear, your electrolyte balance is off and your sodium level is dangerously low. If you see this the next time you visit the bathroom, it's probably best you slow down on the water intake. Haha, what color should my urine be, smart guy? Great question. According to health professionals, the ideal color of your urine should be light yellow. If the color of your urine is excessively dark, you should try your best to consult a doctor. Your health may be at risk. Number 7. Swelling of the hands and feet. Do you guys recall the word hyponatremia? Alright, just kidding. But if the level of sodium in your blood lowers, your body will begin working away to retain the fluid. This may result in painful swelling of the hands and feet. Number 8. Frequent urination. Are you one of those people who feels the painful urge to head to the bathroom every hour? If so, this isn't good. You are supposed to urinate a minimum of 7 times a day. Anything after 7 is considered frequent urination. While several factors contribute to this frequency, anxiety, urinary tract infection, and even diabetes, the most practical reason why you're urinating so much is because you're guzzling down water like a fiend. Number 9. Cramps. This is just an annoying reality of excessive water consumption. Instead of sodium, let's switch over to potassium for a second. Potassium is another essential mineral you need to maintain your muscles, especially ones controlling your heart and lungs. Flushing the potassium out of your body will no doubt drain your energy and eventually weaken your muscles. This can open the door to things like spasms and cramps. It can even lead to intestinal problems. This may sound weird coming from me, but stop drinking the water. Do you drink too much water? Have you been experiencing any of these symptoms? Sound off in the comment section and don't forget to hit the button and subscribe for more great content from your bestie. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or the right video and enjoy.